guaranteed appear on the third floor, and we talk to him there. We want him to appear on the sixth floor, ideally. The sixth floor. And since he won't be on the third floor, since we talked to him, there's a 1 in 5 chance of that being the case. Oh, I see Cypher's waking up now. Cool, cool. So here we go. And then when we get to the sixth floor, that'll be the moment of truth here. The key part of this is, if Pazuzu does appear on the sixth floor, all you have to do is hit that one switch. And then you can just fight him right away without having to go through any of the whole rest of the dungeon after that on the way down. However, if you don't get Pazuzu on floor six, then you have to clear out all the rest of the dungeon and hit all the other switches in order to fight him. And that can take you a lot of time, particularly depending on where he spawns.
We got a couple more donations in. Let's see, Joseph Lapira put in $8.95.
The classic.
We gotta play with power. Hit us up with that power glove. Let's see, Lasnik Titus put in $15. This goes towards Mega Man 2. I appreciate the cause, guys. It's kind of awesome.
Thank you very, very much, everybody, for all the kind words and, of course, the donations.
Let's see. Bronson Roberts put in $10. Zelda, if I haven't missed it yet. If so, then Mario. Random Select TV. And James Moskovic put in another $8.95. I also wish to see more Air Guys instead of the Power Glove game. I missed it last night. Please announce this and get a movement going for more Air Guys. Are we taking counter donations?
Well, the Power Glove goal is really close to being met, so I don't think we can act it at this point, but if y'all want to see more Air Guys, we could do more Air Guys in the stream afterward if people want or something, after the marathon proper is over. That's definitely a possibility. We'll see if Rithley comes back, since he's one of the ones who actually knows how to play that game.
Just a quick reminder of who we are, for those of you just joining us. This is Kings of Poverty, a joint speedrun event by Speedruns Live and Team Spooky. And we are raising money today for Rainn, the rape... what is that? I can't read.
Rape, Abuse, and Incest National Network.
Thank you, FunkDoc. And yep. Right now, FunkDoc is playing Final Fantasy Mystic Quest. He's about two-thirds of the way in.
Yeah, roughly around there.
Something like that.
A little bit less if we get good Pazuzu. In fact, I'm not sure, but under 3 hours might be possible, actually, if we get Pazuzu luck. But we'll see about that. In any case, we will definitely crush the 330 estimate I had for this game. And trust me, we need all the estimate crushing we can get right about now. With how late this thing's scheduled to run. Currently, I'm debating whether to do, Mario RPG or the TMNT run last, because the issue is Cypher has to go to work tomorrow, and we don't want him to screw him up too badly for that, so we'll see depending on what happens, but I'm curious to hear the chat's opinion on this, so would you rather have Mario RPG or NES TMNT with me and Min and your donated mystery partners as the final game? Okay. Actually, yeah. So Cypher said also he could call in sick if need be for work, so we'll see how that goes. Depending on how late this goes, so. We could go either way with this, guys, you know. I'd kind of not want to change the schedule too much at this point, given the shuffling we already had to do for everything that happened last night, but.
Ooh,
again,
wow. I'm seeing a lot of TMNT for last right now.
Yep.
And also, someone mentioned, is Culex a possibility for Mario RPG?
Is Culex a possibility? I don't think so, honestly.
I didn't think so either.
But we can do the 3D maze in Johnny's ship, and we can do have him fight Booster if we hit that lofty $1,000 goal that we have for that. Lots of time until that yet, so you can get a movement started, and you have plenty of time to make that one count. I mean, we'll see. I mean, well, you would have to get Cypher on the stream and ask him about Culex. He, being the one who runs that game and knows more about it than pretty much anybody, he'll be the final word on that. So, never say never, I guess, for now anyway.
And actually, on the subject of turtles, you know, there is a donation incentive for the two other players. And we don't have any donations for that yet.
We had one, I think. I forgot to list it, but I think someone donated $10 to put... I think it was like Arturo and Nerd Josh as Michelangelo and Raphael. Those are the two turtles being donated for. If you check the spreadsheet, you'll see that I will be playing Donatello in that run, and Min will be playing Leonardo. So it's the other two turtles, Raph and Mike, that are open for donations. And currently, Arturo and Nerd Josh have $10 for that. Although I don't think Art's even here right now. I imagine he should be around later, though. Neither of them are actually here right now. But hope we see him soon.
Put that in.
The way the four-player run is going to work, for those who don't understand, is that it'll be like a one-player game, but we'll pass the controller between players each time we switch turtles. That's the idea. Each player only gets to control one turtle. This was inspired by the runs that Min and I would do on that game the last time I was at the Team Spooky House. We would each give ourselves two turtles and switch back and forth, and we eventually both learned to beat that game with no deaths, so... Get rid of the Dullahan clone by any means. A lot of the enemies at this point in the game are quite annoying, though. And it'll only get worse in the last dungeon. Yes, he used silence, the status condition that, as I mentioned, does absolutely nothing in this game. Yo, SNES Final Fantasy programming errors. This game's still nowhere near as busted as FF6, though, as far as that goes. Or even 4. Final Fantasy 4 is getting really broken now. People have found new glitches in that game and are beating it in under 3 hours at this point.
Damn.
Yeah, SirVG on one of the recent streams like a couple days ago, I think he got like 253 or something.
Wow.
Yay, hit the guy who's immune to blindness. And take the free healing opportunity while we can. We're closing in on the moment where we find out if Pazuzu appears on this floor or not. The sixth floor, I mean. The important one. If not, it's going to turn into a wild goose chase, and this will definitely add some time to the run. Do we get it? No, of course not. All right. So what we're going to do is we still have to hit the switch on this floor, so I'll do that. And then since it's right along the way, we'll pick up the flare spell, which will allow Spooby to take out two enemies at once again. It's the strongest spell in the game, as it often is in Final Fantasies. The older ones, at least. The pre-Ultima era. We will do this first, so we'll have flare to use on these fights here. It's a pretty nice time saver, actually. Now that we have Flare, we'll, should make these fights go a little faster, I imagine. Although, no point in using it here when we have, Exit plus Arrow. It's for three enemy fights that, it really comes in handy. Not to mention bosses. Like this. This is a Flare fight right here. Just don't kill Spooby, please. Oh, wait. I said the magic phrase. Damn. At least he's not on the fifth floor. That's a really annoying place for him to be. So that's a good sign. I think we can, as we're going down here, check and see if he's on the fourth. So we can start to play a process of elimination here. Mm. Okay, he's on the fourth, so this is good. We should be able to hit the switch on the second floor and then go back up and fight him here, I think. So this, I would say this is a pretty good spawn overall, given the circumstances. Probably the best we can get short of a sixth floor, obviously. That chest over to the right there has Excalibur, the strongest sword, but I'm not even going to bother getting it. There's no point. Not when we have Exit and all these other ridiculous spells here. They definitely weren't afraid to go all out making magic ridiculous in this game. There we go. Okay. Now this sets up a one-round kill in this fight. The problem with the eyes here is that I think they tend to reflect attack magic back at you, or at the very least it doesn't work on them. So we can't use flare in these fights, not when an eye is present. That guy is resistant to fire, the Chimera, so you gotta take him out first in order for Flare to work right in this fight.
Alright, we got $20 from Justin Porter, and his comment simply says, Power Glove.
We're getting really, really close to that goal now for the Power Glove, guys. Thank you so much.
Yeah, that's currently at $263.95. So about 40 bucks to go. And also I see $20 from Caleb Hart. Or should I say, what was one of the weird names?
Crunch Fitness. Caleb Hart, the new world record holder on Mega Man X, I do believe.
Does he have the record for any and 100%?
I think he got the any percent record back, I thought I heard.
Yeah, that's the one he did recently.
Yeah.
I forget. Yeah.
And he's always had the 100% record. Nobody else runs that game, that particular category near as much as he does. From what I understand. But yes, thank you very much, Caleb. So did he leave any kind of comment, or is that not shown up yet?
It didn't show up yet.
I gotta imagine he'll have something to say. Caleb's a pretty swole dude, for those who don't know. At AGDQ, they did the Space Mutiny thing of just giving him ridiculous muscle man nicknames, so... Yeah, he's pretty deserving of it. And a hell of a speedrunner to boot. One of my own... favorite streams that I have linked on my stream page, and one that I'll frequently link on my Twitter. My Twitter is also SRK FunkDoc. I link a lot of other great speedrunning streams on there, if anybody's interested in that. That's mostly the main thing I use it for, along with giving updates on my own stuff, of course. Alright, so he's not a floor 2. Oh, that's right, duh, that's right. I already know he's on the fourth. Why am I even saying this? I already know. Pazuzu is on the fourth. I always do this, though. We should be close to the end of this dungeon, though, because all we should have to do, I think, is hit the switch on this floor, then go back up the way we came to the fourth, and then fight him there. We should be able to fight him after we hit all the switches, but we'll see if he does the DuckTales thing again. Pazuzu, where are you? Take the safe way here. Get Spooby back. Because of stuff like that. That's why I do that. This could potentially kill me again, but nah, we're okay. We just barely survived that one. Don't miss, thank you. That's another thing in this game. White magic spells can miss sometimes, but black magic and wizard magic spells have 100% hit rate, even when you're blinded. So do bombs. Another one of the main reasons I tend to use so many of those in this run. Now we run flare. Our last flare spell, so we gotta use more seeds. After this dungeon is over, there's only like one long section with a bunch of different fetch quests, and then the final dungeon left. So, really not a whole lot left of this game once we get through here. So, with that in mind, keep in mind that if anyone has the link to the schedule, you can look at that and see the future games, but we have a lot of hype stuff coming up. Konami Wai Wai World, which is a big crossover game with a whole bunch of Konami characters, Simon Belmont, Goemon, Mikey from the Goonies, and King Kong, among others. It's a pretty crazy game, and also probably the scariest game that I run out of everything, so that game could potentially be a blow-up, or it could be the game getting blown up. No in-between. And also, after that will be the original Castlevania, and then I believe Bucky O'Hare with the hard mode one hit deaths run that you all so generously donated for. Let's see, I think we have a few dollars to go on Mega Man's the Mega Man 2 difficult mode speedrun by Cypher. That has a little bit of money left to it. Also, the Bad Street Brawler Power Glove.
Let's see, for difficult mode, we're at $85 right now, so only 15 to go for that. Let me do another check. We got $10 from Dylan Lucas. No comment attached yet. But thank you very much. Just a reminder, all your donations are going to Rainn, the Rape, Abuse, and Incest National Network.
Yep. A charity that does a number of fantastic things. They do a lot with regard to rape crisis hotlines, both like phone and online, and do a lot of work with rape crisis centers. You know, for rape victims, and also a lot of policy work. They do a lot in Washington relating to laws on sexual harassment and sexual abuse. So a lot of great causes all in one there with this charity. And your donations are very, very much appreciated. We should be closing in on like 5,000 total raised, because we have 330 in in-house donations in addition to whatever the chip-in says. So should be close.
Yeah, we're getting there. Chip-in has $4,452.89 right now.
Okay. So, we're getting close to our halfway mark for overall goal in this marathon. Thank you all so much for that. We still got work to do yet, though. For sure. All this to hit that one last switch. Now we'll see if we can fight him on the fourth floor. I think we should be able to, though.
All right, Dylan Lucas's comment came in. Let's get that power glove going. Thanks for the great stream, Spooky, and a great cause to boot.
Thank you very, very much for that donation and the nice words. And we're, getting really close to that power glove goal now.
Okay, so that was a $10 donation. So the power glove is currently at $273.95. Only about $30 more. And Josh will play the game with the power glove. Play Bad Street Brawler. Or at least try to play with the power glove.
No guarantee on how far I get, but we can try. He ran away again. This is what I was afraid of. Alright, we're gonna have to check all the floors again now. Oh boy. This is the not-so-fun part of this dungeon. So I don't know what exactly it takes to get him to stop. Maybe once he leaves a floor? Like, after you hit all the switches, you make him leave a floor, and then the next one he gets on, you can fight him? That's kind of what I'm wondering, if that's not the case. I don't entirely understand how this works. Okay, he's not in the first floor, so that's good to check. Not on the second, obviously not in the fourth, so now we can try up here again and get to the third. Obviously, okay, not here, so choices are getting narrowed down, at least. I think it's just 5th or 6th at this point. It's gonna suck if he's on the 5th, though, because we'd have to fight more extra battles then. I think we should go and see if he's on the 6th first, though. That'll probably take less time than getting into all these fights in the event that we don't have to get into all the fights. Don't worry, folks. There shouldn't be too much more of this left. Yeah, this dungeon gets really long if you don't get the lucky spawn. Okay, so he is on the 5th. I think you want to go down this way anyway, though, because you have to get into the 5th from here to fight him, I think. Yes, indeed. Oh, wait. Actually, no, that's incorrect, so we're going to have to go back around again. So my original idea was right. We're going to have to go onto the 5th floor from the other way and then fight those extra battles to get to him. But then, after that, we definitely should be able to fight him, though. Yeah, when it's random like this, there's just not much else you can do, really. Sad to say. That's why this is my least favorite dungeon by far. All right. Closing in on the end of this, finally. And then, again, like I said, we only have, well, we have one real joke of a dungeon and one real dungeon left after this, so getting close to the end of the game here.
Huzzah.
I also forgot to mention another one. Donation incentive we haven't talked about much yet. Link to the Past, you can donate to choose the file name in that game, also in Castlevania 3 and 4. So you want any particular names for the files in those games, you can get those in whenever you like until the games themselves start. We mentioned the Castlevania ones a number of times, but we haven't seen much action on any of those, so like to get that started, get some bidding wars going. Are people just going to donate Spooby for everything in this, or are we going to see Lunk again like we do in every Zelda thing? Who knows? You will decide. Alright, time to fight this dude. After all this trouble, he is a pretty darn hard boss, so he does live up to the billing. If that were a critical hit, we would have been dead, but lucky it wasn't. Cool, we can go all out on this turn. Flare is a pretty big help against this guy. He's also weak to wind, so we can definitely rack up the damage on him for sure. It's just, now we can't, though, because when he has the Psych Shield on, he reflects attack spells back at you. So I tend to use these turns to just heal up and play it safe here, since we can't get a lot of damage on him anyway. Kaylee can sometimes act before the boss does, but Spooby never can. See, she acted before he took the Psych Shield down, but Spooby's guaranteed to act afterwards, so that's why I can cast a spell with him. This boss has really high HP, so this tends to be drawn out, and you have to be really careful to avoid the petrification and instant death moves this guy has. He's going to Psych Shield again. You can tell because when both of the characters act before he does, he's going to Psych Shield. Great turn there. Fight's looking good so far. He should be getting pretty close to death by this point. Oh man, that was lucky that wasn't a petrify. Yeah, because he's close to death now, so we're just going to go all out with the attacks, I think. There we go, dang. I didn't expect him to be dead that soon. Now I have to remember, pick up the chest with the coin this time. Last time I casted Exit to get out of here before I picked up the chest, or one of my recent practice runs anyway, and you have to go through the whole dungeon and fight all the battles again, so yeah, that's about the worst thing you can possibly do to yourself in a run like this. So I'm going to get the chest. Now we can exit safely. And Now we talk to Otto here again. And our old buddy Ruben is coming back, so we're going to switch out characters now. Unfortunately, Ruben is especially not good for this part. But it's not that hard of a part, so not that big a deal. I guess the same is true of Tristram the second time you get him. So first thing we have to do, we have to backtrack all the way back to Fireburg just so we can talk to Ruben's dad and get an item from him. This is the total fetch quest central of this game right here. So I would say this would be a very good time to point out that we have a number of big hype games coming up. So you want Mario, you want Zelda? Well, it's going to be coming later tonight. Pretty much I tried to save like a lot of the most exciting games, the ones that people want to see the most for the primetime hours. So starting after this, we'll start seeing more interesting games. Konami Wai Wai World, the wacky crossover game with Simon Belmont and other Konami characters. The original Castlevania, Bucky O'Hare with that hard mode donation incentive that has been met. Bad Street Brawler is in there somewhere. Also, the Ninja Kids. That's right. I forgot to mention. You can donate for my co-op partner in the Ninja Kids, a completely insane 80s beat-em-up. And currently, I think we have $50 for Spooky as my partner in that one. And I don't think there's been anything else since. So, if you want to add more to the cause there, now is the time. You can also donate for the file names in a number of games. Castlevania 3 and 4 and Link to the Past. Donate for file names there. We got to finish the donation for Difficult Mode in Mega Man 2. And the Mario RPG, there's $50 to do the 3D maze. And also $1,000 to make Psych for Fight Booster. So we got that out there. Let's try and hit that one, guys. Plenty to donate for yet. Plenty more ways to make your donations count and have it make an impact on the stream too. So, get all that going on here.
All right, so there's some good news with the Power Glove.
Oh!
Mm-hmm.
What would that be?
Daniel Matt donated $100. Donation comment. To finish off the Power Glove goal and to help a great cause. Thanks for the daily hours of entertainment, Josh. One of your viewers.
Thank you,
Silver Star.
Silver Star, yes. Mm-hmm. Thank you very, very much for that one, sir.
So that put it at $373.95. So that's well over the goal.
Awesome. Thank you so much. Now, another thing to keep in mind, too, is the Power Glove that I'll be using for Bad Street Brawler, we will give that as a prize to whoever makes the largest single donation of this marathon. Currently, we have a couple people who've made $100 donations, and I believe that is the largest one so far. I think, anyway. And so, we need to break the tie. We need someone to claim the sole possession of the top spot there. We're nearing the end of the game here, so... Last Dungeon is fairly long, though, so you'll get a lot of action there. And also the music. In my opinion, they saved the best music for last in this game. I think, anyway. But yeah, had to open up that door earlier to go through this, and then get the Mobius Crest, which is required to reach Captain Mac's ship, the next dungeon here. Now we have to talk to Kaylee so we can use the heifer give us the captain's cap, which we need to rescue Captain Mac here. It's faster to use exit to get out of here and go back in compared to anything else. And now we'll go up here, and this will allow us to reach Captain Mac's ship. Flare this one, and I think we can cast life on this guy. Or wait, no, we can't, right? Ah, it doesn't work on him. I forgot. Yeah, so this is not going to be such a great turn. Although we can, I guess we can cast another flare and have Ruben attack, and we'll end the fight here. Never mind on that plan. I guess we could cast white. I forgot Ruben is white now. So we can cast flare and white, both. Man, those guys are relentless with the curing. When they get down into critical HP, they tend to do that.
All right, a few more donations. Thank you, John Fladzinskas, who donated $15, Mega Man 2 difficult mode. So that puts us at the goal for that as well. So I guess we'll be Cypher running Mega Man 2 on difficult mode.
Thank you very, very much for that one. Glad we got that goal hit. That's going to be a heck of a run, I say. Just as it was at Awesome Games Done Quick.
Yeah, I hope so. And another from Kyle Davis, $40. Had to donate some more. You guys are all doing some awesome work for a great cause. Put this on for 96 exit SMW, and if possible, some Dram show off strats.
Okay, well, I'll talk to Dram about that.
All right. Well,
he's here, right? Sorry. Yeah. Man, I didn't even see you took over from Satoru's spot.
Yeah, I snuck in here. Well, Kyle, definitely, I'll try to show off, hopefully not sacrificing.
So what's the standings for that anyway, the 96 versus No Cape, No Star World?
So that actually, No Cape was pretty far ahead. Now, as it stands now, we have $65 for 96 exit and $57 for No Cape, No Star World. So it's pretty tight there. I think I might throw a few dollars in when it comes down to it, too.
Mm-hmm.
For a good cause.
Well, I hate to say it, but I might have a few for No Cape, No Star World when it comes to that. So yes, that is Dram55 on the mic right now, along with me. He is the player who will be running Super Mario World at this, and also, again, the man who made Arturo Sanchez Frey in the Mystery Tournament last night. We just picked up the Gaia's armor, which gives Spooby a lot of elemental resistances. It's right there, so no point not picking it up. Bound to help you more than it hurts. So yes, that was the dungeon. There was no boss there. See what I mean about that being a pretty pathetic one? And now at this point we go to the inn, and that is when we will get our last character and get ready to head to the final dungeon. Yes, it's our old pal Phoebe again. And this is the character whose save file I used to create the glitch for this run. For those who don't know, again, the glitch is that when you save and load a file, the partner from the file you load will, if you then start a new game and never save and load, all your partners will have the elemental and status resistances, as well as a stat boosts, of the partner from that last file you loaded. So it's a way to give your partner like a resistance to, in my case, paralysis, sleep, water, thunder, wind, drain attacks, and maybe like something else really good. I forget, but it's a lot, along with good stat boosts. So this character is the one that I use for the glitch. Phoebe at this point at the end of the game. Yes, heading to the last dungeon now. Get ready for more godlike music. Alright, so after this fight, we will pick up, we'll make a slight detour, and we'll pick up the Aegis Shield for Spooby here. That will give him resistance to paralysis and, most importantly, petrification. Petrify becomes a huge problem as we get closer to the end of this game. More so than it ever was before, so... Even though we lose a fair bit of time doing this and have to fight an extra battle, it is well worth it, trust me. The last floor of this dungeon is ridiculous with that. And now Mega Grenade should end this fight. Oh no, the ninja's still there. Oh well. Whatever. Don't worry, the boss is very soon here. We actually don't need to get into any more battles before the boss, and this boss is a beauty. What? How did I miss that? Oh, I think I pushed down too far there. All right, we gotta do this again one more time. The first time I ever missed that, actually. Seems to be a common theme here for firsts. Alright, let's do this right this time. Don't get greedy. Here we go. Yes, that's what you want. And time for Skulrus Rex. Now they're going to copy and paste all the bosses guarding the crystals. This one, though, blink and you'll miss it. Truly. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Taking a safe, reviving Phoebe for sure. Really don't want to die at this point, not after that, obviously. I think that Ninja might be able to kill me if he self-destructs too, so that was a little bit of a scary situation there. But yes, enjoy that really hard boss there. Well, there's more.
Alright, some more donations. $20 from Jeffrey Kurtenbach. This is for No Cape, No Star World. God bless the rain. Alright, thanks, Jeffrey. $10 from Zamara Rosette. For Mega Man 2 Difficult Mode. Big ups to Spooky for always doing big things. And Speedrun. Speedruns has a new fan. JRXP 2011.
Well, thank you very, very much. If you're getting into speedrunning, if you're just new to it, there is a whole huge community for it now, and a lot of people who stream quite frequently on world record attempts and races and such. So, if you want to see that, you can go to a site I highly recommend, woody.com. It's a W00TY, so woody.com, and that page lists basically every speedrunning stream in existence, and... you can go on there whenever you want, and it'll show you whatever streams happen to be live at that time. So,
yeah, there's a few good places to get good speedrun streams. You got that. You got Thiny D, Minions page.
That's right. I forgot about it. Shoutouts to Minion.
Yeah.
Number SMW. Yes, indeed.
Yep. $10 from Damon Robertson. You guys are awesome. Keep up the great work.
Thank you, thank you.
Thanks, Dan. There's also the teams on Twitch TV. You have Team SRL and Team SDA.
SRL standing for Speedruns Live, for those who may not know.
Oh, yeah. And SDA for Speed Demos Archive.
Yes, so on the team pages for both of those, I think they have a button there you can click, and it'll just have you automatically follow everybody on that team on Twitch. so you'll get email notifications whenever they go live. That's the main thing following does for you, and it also helps us streamers out. So thank you very, very much. Any follows would be greatly appreciated. Yeah, just do that.
Okay.
And I think we got the route right for this with all the switches. There's a lot of switches to remember in this place. I have so many seeds, I can just spam those at this point, really. Oh yes, the boss doing the Super Macho Man peck jiggle there. I always forget about that, but... Oh, wow, this could be really bad, folks. Although, it's a short fight, so we won't lose too much time if we die, but still. We'll see if we can get some healing off here. Don't kill me. Thank you. Alright, we're still alive, just barely. But yes, you can exit that boss as well. Yes. Oh, no. You know what we can do? Just wait. This should end the fight, I think. Yeah. I opened up that door earlier as a shortcut for this. Helps save a little time. Continue the same strat for all these fights. Spam your strongest spells indeed. We have way too many seeds at this point, so we can just kind of do whatever with them. Only a couple more bosses left in this game. Wow. We're gonna die. Oh no, wow! Can't believe it, we just barely survived that one. Much longer before the boss. We'll fight this one extra battle here, even though it's not technically required, because it opens up a pretty significant shortcut. And the fight will be over in just one spell. Like this. This guy is resistant to fire, so we have to both use a white in this fight. Thankfully, his sidekicks are really weak, so we don't have to worry about taking them out specifically. They'll just die as a side effect of using these spells. Go, Spooby, go. Alright, now we can get it set up where... Spooby will cure and Phoebe will use white. Since hers is stronger, obviously. This guy is much, much easier than the original version because he doesn't use that 660 damage to both characters' flame breath move. He does have that though, which is a single version target. does a little bit more damage, but not nearly as scary overall, I would say. HP is not that high either, as you can see. I guess I should have cast Cure instead of Life. Oh wow, perfect. Alright, this works out like perfectly then. And now I think at this point we should be able to just spam our best stuff and run away with this fight. This is a really easy one. That's kind of a scary critical hit though. But this might kill him. This might kill. Yeah. That opens up the next floor. The last floor of Doom Tower here. This is where things really get nasty because they phased out all of the weaker enemies from earlier in the game, and now you only get the best of the best on this floor. There's 10 required fights, I believe, here, and they all suck. They really suck. This is the whole reason I get the Aegis Shield for Spooby. They're being nice here, but I mean, they can use Petrify or Instant Death moves or a lot of other nasty things. Not gonna work on Spooby, that's why I got that Aegis Shield. Look at that, they all keep trying to do Petrify and Instant Kill stuff. That's what I'm talking about with this floor, man. Oh wait, no, we go down here. At least only one spell's needed to take these guys out. Yeah. Any one-turn kill in these battles is always a good thing. The Chimeras are kind of tough to deal with because they're resistant to fire, so you can't really use the same strats you would use in a lot of other cases. So we'll go back to Exit and Life here. These guys aren't much of a threat to Spooby now, so yeah, we can just go ahead and take them out.
All right, another $10 from Kyle Davis. I forgot to say, DHJ here. Just wanted to say, Dram, drop Mario and play a real game like Bobby's World.
Yo, Bobby!
I'll play it, but I'm not looking to drop Mario for it. I think I can get them both going. Have you ever seen that game, Josh?
Which one?
Bobby's World?
I've never actually seen it. I just know that it exists.
But oh, it's a game, yeah.
Yeah.
It's a good game. Solid platforming.
There, the bionic arm actually gets some use in battle for once. The one time in the game you'll get to see that. Let's see if we can take one of these guys out early. Wow, they were nice this turn. Alright. This doesn't matter now because guaranteed to kill either way. Yeah, that's the power of Flare. Hey, we do have one fight with a weaker enemy here, I guess. I forgot about this one. That random snow crab getting stuck in there. This floor has been really nice to me overall so far, but we have a few more fights yet to go where things can go wrong. And the fight's over. All right. Man, they're behaving really well here. Oh, no, I forgot. The Chimera is resistant to it. He's weak to bow and arrow, though, so there's that. Oh boy, another one of these. Actually, I think we might be able to get away with both using white here, and I think that might get the kill. Hey, that works. Alright, so we do have a way to one round that fight. Also, I see Spooby just gain another level. Check this out, my favorite little enemy skip. Go up here, shoop, off to the side. Don't have to fight that guy. Couple more fights, and then we'll fight the Pazuzu clone down there, named Zu. And Zu is actually weaker than Pazuzu. He has less HP, even, and he adds a new move that he'll use quite a bit, which is just, he uses the Psych Shield as an attack, and it only does one damage, so this fight is so much easier than the original Pazuzu one. Plus having a stronger partner, of course. Alright, after this is only the last boss remaining. Stick with the safe strat here. Both using white hopefully will get the kill on them without them doing anything too bad. Hey, I think we got it. Yeah. That's what I'm talking about. He does a one damage move that the original Pazuzu didn't. I've seen people claim that Pazuzu has that move as well, but I've never ever seen him use it. Being nice like this just lets us really get a huge head start on him as far as damage goes. He's already almost dead, look at this. I don't think I've ever had a fight this fast on this guy. And he's weak to a bow and arrow, so I'll just use that on him for some nice extra damage. Now we can go all out, and he could die within this turn, actually. Unless that hits, which it does, of course. Can we get this off? Don't critical hit. If there were critical hit, we would have actually died there. Alright, now the fight should be over. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Alright, so we really don't have much more left to go. After this, it will be Konami Wai Wai World, followed by the original Castlevania and Bucky O'Hare. We got more hype games coming up for you later in the evening, too. Mega Man 2, Zelda A Link to the Past, Castlevania 3 and 4. We could also get some donation fights going for Castlevania 3. I haven't seen much yet as far as character choices in that game. I have, like, a little bit for Sypha, I think $5, and I haven't heard anything for the other characters for donations, so you can choose from any of those partner characters or a Trevor-only run if you so desire. So they all make a huge difference in how I play the game to the point that they're all completely different categories in SDA. So you can also donate for the file name in Castlevania 4 if you want. So there's that. And also Super Mario World. Super Mario World will be one of the last games here, so be on the lookout for that. Final boss time, everybody. So a lot of people know about the glitch on this guy where you can cast Cure on him with Spooby here. However, there is more to it than that, besides just casting Cure. What we do is have Phoebe cast Cure, and heal him some, immediately followed by Spooby who will cast Cure again and do more damage to him. This is a really weird, like, overflow or underflow kind of glitch. I don't know exactly how it works. Oh, it missed. That's kind of bad, but at least we can cast life on Spooby here. Keep him healthy. There we go. We need that cure. And I think this should do it. Oh, shh! Wow, we got that completely wrong. Damn. The strategy for this fight is totally different depending on what level you're at. And the level 23 strat is different from the level 24 one, I guess. Don't even know what to do now. I'm kind of lost. We're actually going to die on this guy, I just realized. I forgot he can do that move. We're dead. We're dead, folks. Alright, well, you know what? This is actually kind of a good thing because it gives us a chance to try this again. So... okay. Let's try this. We'll equip the claw this time for a little bit more magic power. I know the level 23 strategy for this boss, but I'm not usually at level 24, so that's why this one is kind of different and I have to improvise a little bit. But I think we're doing okay now. At least you all get to hear this awesome music. This is my favorite music in the game, I would probably say. Seven, seven, seven. I never noticed that. There we go. Time. All right. So we still beat the estimate by around 20 minutes, even with all the bad luck throughout this run.
Nice.
So there we go. Mystic Quest, ladies and gentlemen. Hope y'all enjoyed this game and the music and everything else. And I'll take a quick break during the ending here, and I'll come right back. We will do Konami Wai Wai World, followed by the original Castlevania and Bucky O'Hare. Those are our next few games here.
Hey Josh, if someone donates like a lot of money towards two different things, do we split it or just put like that much towards you?
If they say in the comment that they want the money to go toward two different things, we can split.
All right, cool. So it was a Castlevania 3 Sypha and a certain file name. So we can just do 100 each. It was $200 total.
Okay. We can do that.
All right.
Awesome.
Okay.
And the $200, I believe, is also the largest individual donation of this marathon now. Mm-hmm. So you were in the lead for the working power glove with sensors and everything.
Yeah, and that's from Daniel Matt or Silver Star.
Silver Star has been quite generous throughout this marathon.
He's got some deep pockets. I'd like to get Josh to run Castlevania 3 with my name on the save. Silver Star or Silver if it's too long, and to select Sypha if possible. My favorite character of my favorite childhood game played by my favorite streamer. Smiley face. I'll be sleeping during the broadcast, but I'll catch up on it tomorrow. Thanks for everyone for what you're doing. All right, thank you.
Thank you very much, sir.
Mm-hmm. And we have a few more with no comment. We have $89.50 from Mark S. Williams.
That's got to have a comment coming.
That was from like 20 minutes ago.
Really?
Yeah.
I wonder if the comment got lost or something, maybe, or just didn't put it in the right place. I've seen a few $89.50 donations. That was the one that got Excalibur into the mystery tournament, and I think we're all very thankful for exposing the world to Dr. Blast, Mr. 8950.
Yeah, I don't see it, but maybe it's on the way. No cape, no stars winning. And I think whatever I put in Josh is just gonna...
Thanks, Spooby, you nut. Great closing words to this game, I must say. Anyway, while the credits will run, we'll probably get more updates on donations and stuff if they choose, and I'll take a quick little break, and I'll be right back with more Konami Wai Wai World. You won't want to miss this game, guys. It's pretty crazy.
Thank you, Mike Z, for your $50 donation. Nothing special, just keep up what you're doing. Cheers. Thanks a lot. Also, we don't have any donations yet for Booster in Super Mario RPG. So maybe Cypher can explain more exactly what that's about. Because I have no clue. But it sounds like fun.
Hey guys, the goal for Booster is it's pretty steep because of how much it changes the run and because it's, you know, just a big time waster. But it is a really fun thing you can make me do in the game. So if you do want to see that, probably start donating for that soon because, you know, $1,000. And I would actually like to do that because I haven't done, any run where I've fought him. And it'd be nice to improvise my strat because I won't have the amulet or anything like that. So
a little improv at 3 in the morning.
Yeah. Yeah, donate for that if you want to see it.
Wow.
I know. No, I mean, wait for me to get back.
So Josh says,
Konami Wai Wai World, I think that's a video. Should be like another
one. I don't want to reach that. Okay, guys, the thing about trying to fight Kulex at the level that I'll be at for a marathon run is that I would pretty much have to lame it out with, like, lazy shell items and probably grinding for rock candies from Mushroom Boy. And, I mean, it is cool to see Kulex, but the process to make sure I beat him is honestly boring, and I don't think we really have time for that. Whereas Booster wouldn't take as much time. So, I don't think we can do Cool X, sorry.
Wow. You gotta be, it's gonna end up like 5 a.m.
Yeah.
I don't think you can do it.
Yeah.
You know, but, yeah, you're not making it.
Yeah.
I'm sure it's gonna be really better. I have eye drops, so I can just like get it right now.
I got pulled through last character.
Systems Wai Wai World.
Yes, yeah, the current Marathon.
Oh, so it's right there.
It's
in
there.
What's going on, fellas? This is Spooky. Anyway, guys, as you heard, FunkDoc is going to be doing Konami Wai Wai World next. So that's the next game coming up. And this game is really, really sick if you've never seen it before. It's a Japanese-only release, and it features some really cool characters from the Konami series and even some characters you wouldn't expect that really probably don't have make much sense being in this game, but it's pretty cool that they're there. So this game is a really interesting platformer. It's got some sick graphics, some cool music, and the mechanics are also very nice. All the characters come from various Konami games, and they carry over a lot of their stuff into the game. So, all right. So FunkDoc is getting ready to set up, so we're going to get it started in just a second. So next up is Konami Wai Wai World, guys, and FunkDoc is one of the experts. Ooh, that game's loud. Ah, sorry, guys. Anyway, FunkDoc is one of the experts at this game, so it'll be a pleasure for me to watch him play this again, and I'm sure that you guys will find it a pleasure as well. So enjoy.
All right, guys, getting back on now. So, Konami Wai Wai World, this will be the next game here. You have Konami Man and Konami Girl. Those are your two starting characters. And yes, Konami Girl is actually a robot. That's, you know, only a little bit creepy, I guess, for Japan anyway. But yeah. And this game is... pretty wacky one. And if you're familiar with Game Center CX, this game has been featured on there in what seems to be one of the more popular episodes of that show. So hopefully I can do better than Arena for you guys.
All right. I'm ready whenever.
All right.
So
So let's say, I'll let you know because I'm ready to go. Start the timer now. So you can pick all these different stages representing different Konami games, but the stage we will begin with here is none other than Castlevania. So yeah, these are your two starting characters, and they're both very basic. Just walk and punch and kick things. They're the same character, practically, except that Konami Girl's attack has a little bit better range, which is why I like to use her on the boss of this level, and prefer her more in general. I often use Konami Man as the sacrificial lamb in a lot of ways. A lot of situations, I should say. So yes, this stage is supposed to be Castlevania. And you'll see what happens after we beat the boss and get through it. Of all the games that I play, this is the one that scares me the most, because a death costs you more in this game than in any other game I play. Even the Castlevanias, so I have to be really on point for the last level in particular. This is kind of like Batman with the punching and jumping through enemies. I'm jumping to bait his bullets in a different direction to make him miss. I'll make this detour for 100 bullets because bullets are really key to this game in a lot of ways. They are your ammo for special weapons, but you also use bullets to buy things. In particular, to revive characters, which costs 100 bullets. That will come into play here. He usually doesn't take this much damage going into this, but we should be okay still, as long as she doesn't get hit here, which I shouldn't unless I do something stupid. There we go. That's a near-perfect boss fight right there. So, in each of these stages, you have to get the key, and what the key is used for, you will find out in a couple minutes, hopefully.
Oh, no, I had a sample for you. I'm just gonna let Josh run most of the stuff about this.
Yeah. There we go, we made it through the toughest parts of this stage, so we're good. Falling into pits is instant death for your character and quite a disaster here, if that were to happen to me at this point in the game, which I have done before. I also have a world record run in this game. In fact, I beat an established Japanese record. I played this game live on the stream of a famous Japanese gaming streamer named Dogma Kazami. And I was on, I think, Ustream and Nico both when I did that. In fact, he gave me a Famicom and this game along with a couple others. He wanted me to break the record in this game.
This game is really sick, though. To be honest, before you had started talking about it, I had only known of its existence, but I hadn't really seen it. Now that I have, this game is really cool, not only for the choice of characters that they put in the game, but they also carry a lot of elements over for the characters that came from other games, like the various sub-weapons that they have and stuff like that. This game has a lot of good stuff going for it.
So up here, we're going to meet our old pal Dracula. He lags the game horribly, so it's very easy to screw up these jumps. You have to keep mashing A when you get close to the edge, because you can get dropped inputs when the game lags. So there you go. We just rescued Simon Belmont. And check out what happens to the music when I switch to him here, which I will as soon as I get past these jumps. All right. Yes, it's the classic Vampire Killer theme. And take a hidden staircase here. Ooh, I thought I was going to miss that jump again. I've done that before, and it just really screws up the whole run, especially if you lose Simon. But yes, there we go. Hidden exit teleporter is here, so we don't have to backtrack. But yes, that trip allowed us to pick up the cross, which is Simon's special weapon. Going into this room, it fully heals all your characters, so I go in after each stage. Next stage we'll be visiting is the Goonies. And again, we will have to use Konami Man, as this time he really will be a sacrificial lamb. You'll see later. I did the first task of this game back in 2004. But at the time, I didn't know about a lot of the more interesting tricks that you'll see later. So, in fact, my best real-time speedrun in this game has actually beaten my tasks, my old tasks. So, it's come a long way, that's for sure. When I was trying to beat the Japanese player's record, I couldn't do it at first, and I thought, I couldn't believe his time was legit until I learned some of these things. This part is some tight jumping here. We need to land on the edge of a platform and punch these guys out with Konami Man. That's pretty tight spacing there on these. So we made it through this with full health on Konami Man. That's a very good sign here. Because we're going to have to take a lot of damage to get through this place. This game has a reputation for being very hard, and it is a well-deserved reputation. This game is full of just all kinds of cheap hits and lots of spots in general where it's just near impossible to avoid damage. The squid forever chasing the American dream and destined to fail. Oh, lucky health drop. Cool, we can get through this part faster. Like so. So we can take a hit here now. And check this out. So we make this jump to get the key, and we intentionally kill off Konami Man. Why? Because that warps us back to the beginning of this room here, which means that we can just go forward here and we don't have to backtrack. Normally you have to spend minutes backtracking through this after you get that key if you want to get through it without dying. Now I have to take it a little more careful at the end here, but this is fine. Can't afford to lose any more characters, for sure. Take this one hit as you walk through here, and you won't have to take any more hits for the rest of this section. At least not from those weird mutant sea anemones or whatever those things are. Not sure what they have to do with Goonies, but hey. And fittingly enough with the Goonies, here's Mikey. Use the key to rescue him. And you'll get to hear his music in the next stage. And for now, here's the hidden exit teleporter. The next stage that we go to does not have a hidden exit teleporter. It is the only one that does not, so we'll have to backtrack the old-fashioned way. And now here we're going to go and revive Konami Man, which costs 100 bullets. Next stage is New York City, fittingly enough, for this marathon. And yes, here's Mikey with that Cyndi Lauper theme. The funny thing is, even though people often say the original Goonies game was never released in America, it actually was. Just not on console, but it was released on, I think it was the Versus NES arcade system. Because our dentist's office, back when I was a kid, had one of those. So I actually got to play this game as a kid. I mean, the original Goonies, I meant. Not this game. What? Okay, cool. Health drop. I'll take it. There we go. Only taking one hit from there is really good luck. Now time to switch to Konami Man. Because, again, it's Sacrificial Lamb time. That was pretty lucky to get through there with that little damage. I'll wait for these things to explode so we don't get hit. And then, this is where things get really rough. I'm using a little glitch here. Notice how I zip out the side if I switch characters after a certain point there when going through a tight passage with Mikey. Yeah. Neat little glitch saves a tiny amount of time. Wow. Konami Man has great health going into this. So we can go through this section faster and not have to worry about damage so much. Cool. There we go. And now time to input the suicide code. It's up, A, B, and select. So we instantly kill Konami Man and warp back to the beginning of this long room. So another nice time saver there. So that's another cool trick right there. With certain enemies, if you hit them and then walk through them, the game will think you took a hit, but actually you don't take any damage. So basically you use it to get free invincibility. There we go. We can take one more hit with her now. And then switch over to the old vampire killer. Oh, he has full health too. Wow, I'm in unusually good shape for this point. As you notice, Kong stage is really rough because you're not meant to have this few characters going into the stage. There's one other character that we'll get later who's meant to be gotten earlier. So yeah, for those who couldn't tell, Simon is probably the best character in this game. Simon and the next character we get here, anyway. Simon's case, the cross just destroys most of the bosses, as you could probably tell from that Robo-Kong fight there. He does even better on some of the other ones with the cross. But yes, here's King Kong. Might as well use Simon while the health is still good. More Vampire Killer, I'm sure, won't hurt for the stream monsters. Here comes a wall jump glitch. If you stand next to a wall with a smaller size character, jump and then switch to Kong, you'll get stuck inside the wall because Kong's sprite is wider than the other characters. And so you can use that to actually jump off of the wall. I used that a couple other times over the course of the game. Oh yeah, that's right. Okay, use Kong to jump over this instead of taking the stairs. So the reason King Kong is in this game, for those who may not know, I mean, a lot of people know about Konami's Goonies games, but not nearly as many people know that they made a King Kong game as well, based on one of his random movies, I forget which. It was an 80s one, I think. The game was called King Kong 2, and that was also only released on the Famicom, like this game. We will not be reviving Konami Man for the next stage. Oh, no. Now we are literally going to hell to rescue the hero of a Team Spooky favorite game, Getsufumaden. Yes, indeed, Fuma, whom some of you may recognize from Castlevania, Harmony of Despair, as one of the DLC characters, I believe. Yes, that Fuma. He is available in this game as one of your heroes, so. There we go, we have to be careful with health here. And now they just go over the top with health drops, jeez. The thing with Kong is you notice he jumps higher than the other characters, so you need him to get through Fuma stage, this one. But on top of that, Kong also does double the damage of the other characters with both his normal attack and his special weapon. The special weapon's just not worth going out of the way to get, as are, well, not many of them besides Simon's. But Kong and Simon are the two best characters in this game, hands down. So they're the ones I tend to protect the most, usually. All these enemies, I think, take two hits to kill with the other characters, to give you an idea. Mikey is Operation Meat Shield right now, and he did his job. So now we need Kong for this because we're fighting Belmont skeletons here, as I like to call them. Don't ask me what these guys are doing in a Getsufumiden stage, but, you know. I learned not to question a lot of things about this game. There we go. So we got the cape, the flashing item there we just picked up. That allows Konami Man and Konami Girl to fly. And flight is, I don't know how you're supposed to do this next room without it, to be honest. I'm pretty sure the game specifically intended for you to get flight for this next room, because watch this. So what we have in this room is miniature versions of every boss from Getsufumiden. Look at all this going on below. Like, how are you supposed to get through this without flying? Oof.
Even flying, you gotta take hits.
Indeed. Avoid the head, though. The head does something like 6 or 8 points of damage. He is scary mofo. So, I just base everything around avoiding the head. You see what I mean there? Take the hit there. I don't mind. As long as we survive. All right. Thankfully, this boss is a joke. That's what the cross does, guys. And now we rescue Fuma, known key needed in this level, and we will get his special weapon. Now time for mass suicide. That's right, we are going to input the code to kill off every character. So here's what happens when you lose all your characters and continue. You lose half of your bullets, and you only get Konami Man and Konami Girl back. That's why I don't just use that to death warp out of every stage. But this one, in that particular case, this stage has something special which allows me to get away with that, and thus make it a pretty big time saver overall. This is actually probably the easiest stage in the game. This or Castlevania. Those are the only two stages you can realistically complete from the start of the game. But the reason I don't go to Goemon stage until here is because you need flight in order to get a special item in this stage. And the route that I use is the fastest route to get flight in the first place. Here we go, slot machine time. So what you can do is you can pause to rig the slots, essentially. If you see the apple when you pause and then immediately press A when you unpause, you're guaranteed to get the crown. And if you get 3 crowns, then guess what? All your characters are revived with full health. That's why I did that suicide death warp out of Fuma stage there. So yep, back to full strength for everybody now. And here's the part where we need flight. Because here we're going to get the Gradius power-up. What that does is it permanently doubles everybody's attack power for the rest of the game. So as you can see, it's clearly a pretty big deal. So that's where the whole route for this game is designed around getting that item as quickly as possible. Yeah, here's some Fuma for you. You may recognize that music from CDHD. I'll give you a little bit more of it later. For now, we're going to go and get the key here. There isn't really a boss in this level per se. We have some giant dragons, though, that like to follow you around and take a bunch of hits. We're not going to concern ourselves with killing them, though. And in case you were interested, this game has a sequel also on the Famicom, actually. Konami Wai Wai World 2. Here's some Fuma now. The hype music for you. This is Min's favorite character because he's such a big fan of Getsu Fumaden, I think. The game in general. And yeah, this music. Can't really argue against this. Wait, why didn't it go to Mikey? Whatever. Cool, I actually dodged a hit there because of him being so short. I didn't realize that. Alright, so... gonna wall jump over this way. Dang. And that's Goemon's special weapon there. We don't really need it per se, but it's just along the route, so we get it, because why the hell not? Fly over this wall, and then we'll be on our way to the exit teleporter. The hidden one, rather. Go in here for the health refill. And then... time for the two toughest stages in the game. We're going to Easter Island on this one. We'll need Kong again. With the Gradius power-up, he can kill these enemies in one hit. What the hell? They shoot fireballs too? Jeez. I was hoping for health drops, but whatever. And now we'll be using flight again for this part, because we gotta deal with Godzilla here. Wow, we're getting a terrible pattern in the boulders here. This part's random. Real random. Wow. We might conceivably die here. Alright. Whew. Wow. No mercy in those rocks, man. So here's Goemon's special ability. He can open up those boxes with question marks. Ooh. All right, did we do it? Oh, we did it, we did it. I cannot believe we actually pulled that off. That was real scary there, guys. Okay, so who is this health going to go to? Let's say Konami Man, because why not? And here is a special item, the rice ball. This is an item from another Konami game called Hinotori. And it's a one-time use item. What it does is if you lose all your health on a character, it automatically instantly restores them to full health. But again, it only works once. And you have no choice on when to use it. Wow, lucky health drops. That's big. That's real big right there, because I was getting scared. The dragon does a ton of damage if you touch its body, not so much if you just get hit by a fireball. Alright, we're actually in really good shape going into this boss here. And now time for the boss. I'll kill these guys to reduce the lag. There we go. We got him. So that boss, because of how small its hitbox is, Simon's Cross is actually not the best way to fight that boss. Kong's punches are what are the most effective for speed there. I use a much safer strat in that boss than I normally do. I don't stop to kill the little Mawais, I just go straight ahead, but I've lost the rice ball on that boss a number of times and just really don't want to risk it here. Death in this game, again, it's more costly than in any other game because you get taken back to the beginning of whatever room you're at when you lose a character. So, boss's health also gets restored. Anyway, here comes the Moai head. Your one chance to hear his theme. He can also break blocks, thanks to that hard head of his. There we go. And there's Hidden Exit Teleporter. Let me make sure we still have the rice ball. Yes, we do. We're good to go. Refill health, and then we're going to go to the last couple stages here. Now, for this one, we're going to be doing a shmup. You can choose here between Vic Viper or Twinbee, but this choice here doesn't matter because you can switch between them at any time in the stage. Just by pressing the select button. However, Vic Viper is the far stronger of the two. There's no real reason to use Twinbee in this. Vic Viper has a more damaging secondary weapon, the homing missiles. They do ridiculous damage in this, actually. Much more than in Gradius games. Meanwhile, Twinbee gets the rocket punch, which is more straightforward and not homing, and also less damaging. There's the rocket punch. Ooh, we got an option. Cool. If you shoot the clouds, you'll make bells appear, much like in Twinbee games, and you can shoot the bells to get power-ups. Oh, we're really getting two options already? Seriously? Wow, we already got both our options. We're in a pretty incredible shape for this. I generally like sticking with just two speed-ups here. Not a fan of going any higher. I don't know what death costs you in these stages exactly, other than losing your speed-ups and options. I think what it is you have one life in the stage for each of your characters, but dying in this stage has no impact on the rest of the game. You might just game over if you lose all your characters here or something. So there's Twinbee's upgraded weapon, the Ripple Laser. I think you can only have one of those on the screen at a time, so it's actually pretty crappy compared to Vic Viper's upgraded weapon, which we'll see here, the Laser. This one you can just hold it down and just steady stream of fire, just like in the Gradius games. When I said Konami crossover game, I really meant it. They threw in just everything in this, just about. Heck, have you even noticed they have Pentaro manning the teleporter?
That's cool.
Yes, the penguin you may remember from Parodius and Antarctic Adventure, among other games.
Josh actually has two options, but because of the flicker there, oh, now you can see it, kind of.
Flicker gets pretty bad in some spots in this stage, so. since this isn't the arcade, we can't get three or four options. Sorry. Sprite limits. Wow, we almost got hit there. Okay, we got the shield, so we're pretty safe now. There's another shield drop later on, too, not that we really need it.
Oh, so Nerd Josh and Fublot are coming back to next level. So
awesome.
That helps for the TMNT run. I don't know the status of Arturo, though. I don't know if he's going to make it today because it's kind of a trek for him from Queens to get here. So there's a possibility that he may not be able to show up today.
So now we're getting close to the end of the stage, as you can tell from the music change. A little bit more to go through. We'll get to the boss. And then after that, the final level. And the last level is just the whole reason that I tend to be scared running this game live. We'll see how it plays out, though. The important thing for the last level is to keep the rice ball all the way until the last boss, so that you can use Simon and essentially give him two lives with which to spam crosses on the boss. You can actually destroy these hands, although it doesn't look like you can. The missiles do so much damage that, in effect, you can. Probably reduces some lag, too. Even though you see that head, you don't actually fight her. She just fires those things, I guess. And then we're gonna get the real boss. This thing. Whatever this thing is supposed to be. Dying isn't too big a deal. Just do this here. And that's the boss. All right. This room sucks. Wow, we got really lucky with this one.
That was
oh
nice.
My god.
And you got the invincibility.
You
glitch.
Never get through this room with no damage. Never. Wow, nice. This is a big, big deal right now. Oh my god, that was so close. Although Simon took a hit, though. That sucks. Forgot we're supposed to switch to Fuma, not Simon.
You can actually destroy that enemy, but Josh is taking the hits because it allows him to progress past those pillars really quickly.
Here is a full health potion, but the problem with that is you have to fly to be able to pick it up, so only with Konami Man here. Alright, things are going to be kind of risky here, because Kong's taken so much damage. I might just try and farm for some health drops for Kong here. That's exactly what we needed. Yes, we made it. All right, that's the toughest switch right there. You have to switch characters 5 times after taking that one hit from Konami Girl before you run out of the invincibility, or else you will lose your rice ball. So we did it, guys. Although, there's still the boss to get through. We don't usually take this much damage on Konami Girl here, but it's okay. The fireballs have enormous hitboxes and also do much more damage. Time for the last boss here. Now we need Simon. So let's figure this out. So what we do with Simon is if he runs out of health, we switch 3 times and go to Mawai, and then that should be enough to kill him, ideally.
I hate this boss. It's so ridiculous. Look what he's doing. Alright, so there's the health refill. Oh, you got some health too. Nice.
Yes, got it. There we go. Wow, no death run in this game, other than the intentional deaths. That is no easy feat, guys. So yes, we're going to let Triumphant Mawai here get the killing blow and then make the escape. Here's a cool glitch coming up. Watch this. If you attack and then leave a room, then get this. Mawai is stuck in his attack animation the whole way here. And then you can press B again to get rid of it. The thing with Mawai is, he's not a bad character in general. It's just his normal attack is so slow that I generally prefer using Kong. I also like using Mawai or Kong for this section because they jump higher than the other characters, making it that much easier to get through this and not die in any of these jumps. Not that it's that hard, but still. Mawai, the headstrong one. Sorry.
It looks like he has a back problem right now.
The funny thing is, the glitch actually helps me to line up the jumps, too, because you can see when his feet are close to the edge, and that's when you know to jump. And I'll let him pilot the Vic Viper to victory. We'll kind of hit the timer now. Oh, whatever, but a little bit late, but still.
A little.
So this is the best run I've had on this game in all of my marathon practice attempts, so I'm really pleased with this one. This was the game that scared me the most going into this marathon.
That's great. So what is your world record time in this game?
My world record time in this game is just a hair over 33 minutes. I use a lot of really crazy, risky strats.
That was a near perfect run as is. So the fact that you can shave 3 minutes is crazy.
Because I just go faster through a lot of parts and I just have to pray for health drops.
I got you.
And it's not consistent strats at all. The other thing, too, in the world record run is I play a gambling game in the Goonies stage that gives you more bullets if you guess right on a 50-50. On dice, and that gives you more bullets. And what I do there is I kill all my characters to get out of Kong stage, to warp out of that one, and then pay more bullets to revive characters and such. It's a really risky strat you can't count on for this. Because of the dice game, you get double your bullets if you win, but you lose half of them if you lose.
I see.
So it's really annoying to do, but you have to do it for a world record run. So that's the run I submitted to SDA.
So there you go, guys. Konami Wai Wai World. And once again, this is Kings of Poverty, put together by Speedruns Live, Josh the FunkDoc, and the whole crew. And again, if you're enjoying what you see, please donate. This is all going to a good cause. It's going to Rainn, which is the Rape, Abuse, and Incest National Network. And these guys work tirelessly to really, you know, put together something very nice for everyone. So please donate if you can. And again, there are some donation incentives. I'm going to link to you guys the remaining games in the stream chat right now so you can see what's up. If you want to donate towards a certain game, please make sure after donating to leave a comment behind. If you don't leave a comment, then we can't count you. So please keep that in mind.
All right. I'm going to take a quick look at donations and such.
Sure.
I'll do that.
I think one or two did come in while you were playing.
Okay. So I'll take a look at that. Uh-huh. And then we'll get to the original Castlevania. So we got to switch over to the NES now.
Okay. I'll take care of that in just a second. Let me just link this stuff out to everyone. So there you go, guys. I just copy-pasted the link with the schedule for today. And here is the donation URL. It's here. So anyway, guys, we're going to switch. Are there any incentives to Castlevania 1? Let me see. I need to look at this myself instead of asking. That would be a better idea. Nope. All right. Wow, 20 minutes Castlevania, huh? Yo, FunkDoc. All right, guys, I'm going to switch over the console. So give me just a second.